This webcast, Searching for Bid Solicitations in COMMBUYS, will be most useful to vendors looking for bid solicitations in COMMBUYS, the Electronic Market Center for the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. This webcast is being presented by the Training Office of the Operational Services Division of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. This webcast will cover four quick topics: bid solicitation notifications and terms to know, and searching from the public view of COMMBUYS, and also once you've logged in. Before moving on in this webcast, let's go over COMMBUYS terms you should know. First, a bid solicitation is often referred to as just bid in COMMBUYS. Bid solicitations are published records for the purpose of notifying businesses that the Commonwealth seeks to procure commodities or services. They can also be used to announce upcoming procurements and request information from prospective bidders. COMMBUYS uses the term quote to refer to a response to a bid solicitation. For executive agency goods and services procurements, vendors submit response documents electronically through COMMBUYS. Depending on what the agency has requested in the bid solicitation, the quote may or may not include pricing. Both the bid solicitation, or bid, and the quote are file types in COMMBUYS. Bid solicitations typically include file attachments, as do quotes. The bid opening date will be listed on bid solicitations. It includes both the date and the time that a bid solicitation closes. COMMBUYS will not accept quotes after the bid opening date. Effectively, it is the deadline for quote submission. For more information about creating a quote, check out the webcast, How to Create a Quote in COMMBUYS. It's right here on our YouTube channel. COMMBUYS does provide a number of ways to search for bids. However, perhaps the easiest way to find out about opportunities is through notifications and alerts. Several communications are delivered via email. When commodity codes, we use United Nations Standard Products and Services codes. Included in a bid solicitation match commodity codes included in your COMMBUYS business account, an email is sent to the email address specified in your account. For this reason, as a best practice, set up your COMMBUYS account to include all possible commodity codes that may apply to your business. The official OSD newsletter, by the way, often includes details about upcoming procurements. Email notifications are sent to all COMMBUYS registered vendors once a month when By the Way is published. Similarly, once a month or so, OSD publishes a COMMBUYS business bulletin with tips and tricks for using COMMBUYS and details about procurement activity. The business bulletin is delivered to your email box. Periodically, COMMBUYS will send out other communications and alerts. So, if you receive an email from OSD or from COMMBUYS, it's a good idea to give it a quick read. Additionally, COMMBUYS publishes notifications on the landing page. The slide shows the link for newly posted bids. Finally, you may see notifications from time to time in your seller control center when you are logged into the system. As I mentioned, COMMBUYS provides several ways to search for bids. In this webcast, I will cover searching by bid number, searching by organization, searching by UNSPSC code, and finally, searching using the description field. Email notifications may include bid numbers. Now, when a buyer posts a bid solicitation, COMMBUYS issues a bid number, which is a long string of letters and numbers. Each section means something. Understanding the sections can be useful. For starters, BD simply means bid solicitation or bid. The next number, in this case 17, reflects the fiscal year when the bid solicitation was posted. The next four-digit section is the numerical code for the organization that posted the bid. The next two sections reflect the department and location of the buyer organization. And finally, the last section reflects the numerical bid number. Next, I'll show you how to use this knowledge when searching. To search without logging in, simply open your browser of choice and type www.combuys.com into the address box. Shown here is the COMMBUYS landing page. Lots of information is available without logging in. Using the contract and bid search, you can find current and historical bid solicitations. Let's start there. Notice the Browse by Category box in the lower left-hand corner. Contract and bid search is the fourth option. On the next screen, click the radio button for bids. COMMBUYS will generate an advanced search form, which offers a number of fields for searching. Let's start by entering the numerical part of the bid number we looked at before, 13972. To activate the search, click Find It or press the Enter key on your keyboard. Scroll down to see the results. As you can see, three bid solicitations contained the numbers 13972, but two of them do not follow the COMMBUYS numbering model. They originated before the Commonwealth adopted COMMBUYS. You can click the hyperlinked bid number to see more information, which I will demonstrate shortly. For now, though, let's use the bid number to extract the organization number, in this case, 1080. Let's do a new search for all bids Organization 1080, OSD, posted in COMMBUYS. Click Clear to clear the search form. Now, click the drop-down arrow in the Organization field. From here, scroll down to Organization 1080, OSD. Click Find It or press Enter on your keyboard and COMMBUYS retrieves the results. In order to see them, scroll down. This search returned over 1,500 results, including currently available opportunities and those whose bid opening dates have passed. From the public view, the column headings will sort the results. Click the column heading Bid Opening Date to put the results in chronological order. If the selection Search Using All of the Criteria is active, you can add a search term to further filter results. For instance, let's add a UNSPSC to this search. Click the UNSPSC Segment and Family drop-down arrow. COMMBUYS displays a selection box. As a shortcut to scrolling through the possibilities, type the first number of the UNSPSC code you are looking for. For example, type a 7 when looking for 7210, the code for building construction and supplies. Typing a 7 displays the first UNSPSC code to start with a 7. Scroll from here to reach the desired code. To further filter, also select a UNSPSC class. COMMBUYS displays all class codes that apply to the chosen segment family. For this demonstration, though, I am leaving the class code blank. Click Find It or press Enter on your keyboard. Like before, scroll down to see the results. As you can see from this and previous searches, all results display a bid number, the buyer's name, a description, and the bid opening date. To see bid solicitation details, click the bid number that interests you. The bid header includes relevant details, and as you can see, the file attachments area includes a number of documents relevant to the opportunity. Clicking the document's hyperlinks will initiate document download. Scrolling down further reveals the items or categories for the opportunity, with a UNSPSC code and a description. So you can gather all the information about a bid solicitation without logging in. Scroll down to the bottom of the screen and click Exit, which brings up the previous page. Click Exit again to return to the COMMBUYS landing screen. You can also search once you have logged in to COMMBUYS. In order to search for bids, you must be in the seller role. Click the account icon and then the down arrow to see your COMMBUYS credentials. Make sure the seller role is selected. Near the account icon is another icon that looks like a gear. Click that and then select Advanced Search. Next, click the drop-down area in the Document Type field and select Bids. The resulting form is identical to the advanced search form we saw from the public view, with all of the same field choices demonstrated before. This time, let's search using the bid description field. For statewide contracts, the bid description will always include a name that follows a naming convention, three letters for the category plus two or three numerals. TRD03 is in the trades category. It also happens to be the third opportunity in the category. Let's type TRD03 in the bid description field. Click Find It. As you can see, just one result appears this time on a new screen rather than below the search form as it did from the public view. Notice the bid opening date. As I mentioned before, the COMMBUYS clock shown here is the timekeeper for all COMMBUYS transactions. Just like from the public view, the COMMBUYS bid number is a hyperlink. Click it to view bid details. When you are logged in, the next screen asks whether or not you want to acknowledge the bid. Clicking Yes will trigger notifications of any amendments or updates to the bid solicitation. If you click No, you will still be able to view the bid details. Here, you are viewing the bid header, the same information that displayed from the public view. Here, we can see that TRD03 is a statewide solicitation. We can see the bid opening date. Also notice the bid opening date occurs a year after the solicitation was available in COMMBUYS. This solicitation has rolling enrollment, meaning that the vendor quotes can be submitted and evaluated for an extended time, even after some businesses are selected as contractors. The attachments are also available here, and scrolling down would reveal the same items that we saw from the public view. In the event you need assistance beyond this webcast, go to our webpage. www.mass.gov/OSD has links to most of our tools and resources. Especially useful is a section that includes offices and programs, key resources, and publications and reports. Find the OSD training webpage under Programs and Offices. OSD training offers instruction in a variety of formats, face-to-face, live webinars, and pre-recorded webcasts found right here on our YouTube channel. The COMMBUYS Help Desk is accessible by phone or email. The toll-free number is 888-627-8823, and the email address is commbuys@state.ma.us. Finally, check out the description box below the YouTube viewing area for additional links to job aids and other resources.